Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. Now, as an engineer for CSX since 1999, I have seen pretty much everything I think there is to see when it comes to the railroad. And I'd like to use my experience to teach people on YouTube of how the railroad really works. There's a lot of people that are just starting their first layout or maybe been into the hobby for a little bit, but they just don't have as much knowledge. And a lot of times they reach out to me in an email or message looking for help. So that's why I make these videos. Now, the first thing I like to tell you is pay attention to what the purpose of a railroad is. It's not just to go in circles for our entertainment. It is to move a product from point A to point B. Now, a lot of times that product, something like coal or coke, can be transported in the rain. It doesn't matter. They can be in what's known as an open hopper. It doesn't matter if they get exposed to the elements. But there are a lot of products that you have to keep protected, and you'd put that into a covered hopper. And I want to show you, there are covered hoppers everywhere. In fact, I just picked up some from my layout, and I'll cover those in a little bit. But let's take a look at the covered hopper, some of the industries that you can model. I really think once you watch this whole video, you're going to have a totally different appreciation for the covered hopper. And a lot of people looking for ideas of what to model, here we go. The first thing I'm going to tell you is in Western Pennsylvania, we move a lot of sand. Sand for fracking. And that's just a very big industry in Western Pennsylvania. And so you are going to see covered hoppers moving a lot of sand. Now, you don't want to get this wet. That's why it's in the covered hoppers. Also, a huge, huge industry is coming online pretty much any day now in Western Pennsylvania, and it is going to be plastic pellets. So here we're looking at McKee's Rocks, and I'm going to give you a heads up. They just built, I think it's like an 18-track yard just for staging, and I'm going to cover staging in a future video. But we're going to be staging a lot of these covered hoppers here. Now, covered hoppers are going to come in different sizes because let's think about this. You really don't want something so heavy damaging your tracks. And so they make these cars in different sizes. Now, if a product is going to be very, very compact, very dense, something like sand where it's going to be heavy, they'll probably put that into a smaller car. But something like plastic pellets, okay, just kind of think of, maybe think of ping pong balls. Look at it that way. If you think of ping pong balls, if you filled up a bucket with or a box with ping pong balls, there's going to be still a lot of room for air. It's not going to be as heavy and that dense, and therefore something like that you can get into a larger car without having all that weight on the wheels or on the trucks, whatever, however you want to say it. So think about that. Like, if your product is going to be very dense, very heavy, go with a smaller car. Or if it's going to be something more light, like actually a lot of the larger covered hoppers carry grain. So think about a box of cereal, just a box of, we'll say, Frosted Flakes, and how light that box is. Think along that line. That you're going to get away with a larger hopper car. Now, we move a lot of, besides the sand, there's other products like silica. We move a lot of salt. There's just so much products that you don't want to get wet that you're going to want a covered hopper. Now, they've been around for a long time. Like, look closely. You see that covered hopper right there? That's Norfolk and Western. So that car has been around for quite a long time. Now, we are at Edgar Thompson's steel mill where these covered hoppers are carrying lime, which is used in the process of making steel. So many different industries that you may not even realize really do need these covered hoppers. I don't think it makes too much of a difference if they're smooth side or ribbed side. It might just be based upon the manufacturer or the product. I'm not really too sure. But they all work basically the same way. They get loaded at the top, and then they rely basically on gravity to be unloaded from the bottom. They're all going to have the chutes on the bottom, and they're going to be gravity dropped the product into chutes and then into conveyor belts. And that's a very simple thing that you can model. Now, speaking of modeling, one of the coolest things you can do as a modeler is to weather these cars. And you can't overdo it. And this is proof. This is cars that are filled with salt. And they're going to weather the most. So if you have an industry that gets salt, maybe they ship it on truck for driveway salt or for highway salt, it will really weather the freight cars. And so if you want to practice weathering, these are the cars to practice on. You can't overdo it, and that is proof. So I'm going to show you what I decided to get and why I decided to get these cars from Athearn. So on my new N Scale layout, I mostly run Amtrak, but I also have one section where I run CSX, one section where I run Norfolk Southern. And for the CSX, I have like a mixed freight train, and I wanted to add cars basically similar to what we see right about here. Because most of the covered hoppers that I see are gray, but we do sometimes see this like a burgundy color. And so I thought, okay, let me see what they have, and look at this. Actually, I think it's the lighting in my downstairs. They're actually a little bit more burgundy looking than in this video. But yeah, super detailed. These are the Athearn, I think, what are these called? The PS 4427s, three bays. And I like the body mount couplers. That's what I want. I just want performance. I don't want stuff to derail. I want stuff to couple. I like, you know, of course I'm going to weather these. I was having some fun. I decided to like act like I got DP, and let me shove it. It was actually a big train, and I shoved it around a curve, kind of a tight curve, and no problems. So let me do some rough train handling, like in the real world. Watch this. And no problems. And so that's really what I want, especially in N Scale. I don't like derailments. I want stuff to couple the first try, and I want good details. And so these cars work that perfectly. So I think they're available also like in HO, but this is what worked for me. And I bought the 3-pack. That way I don't accidentally buy the same road number twice, which I've done in the past. So yeah, very happy. Athearn, you put out good stuff always. So very soon, this yard will be filled with covered hoppers, and that's why I'm glad I got this video out for you. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, DJ's Trains, please do so, because you're going to want to see the video I'm doing about here and staging yards for your layout. So subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains. You can also follow me on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. And if you want to connect with me, I can't answer every email that I get or message. There's just too many of them and not enough hours in the day. But if you were in the Patreon site, that is a better chance for us to interact one-on-one. So look in this video's description for the Patreon. Sign up for the Patreon, and I can help you out better that way. And speaking of Patreons, I want to introduce my newest Patreons. William Kohei and Marcus Mattern and Rob McIver and Kevin Zay. Man, I appreciate you guys so much. Patreon, there's a lot of behind the scenes and pictures that you, and videos you'll see before anybody else, and even some Patreon only videos, stuff that puts you in with all the cool kids. You get to see all the stuff first. All right, so check that out in this video's description, and I'll see everybody else in the next video. Yeah, I'm kind of losing my voice, man. Wow. Let me clear my throat.